I had just had Quinn, and so now they're 8 and 5, and Quinn's only known me like this. She knew me when I was bald, but I don't think she remembers it, only from pictures. But Elliot does remember, and he remembers when I had long blonde hair down to my waist. And he asks sort of random questions sometimes, like, is that thing in your head still there? You know, what's happening with that? And for me, I was never going to not talk about it with my kids. And I think my husband could see that. And so we just sort of immediately, we didn't say, oh, I'm going to die. And, you know, but we were like, this is a possibility. Right. And, you know, it has terminal disease. So it's like, we had to explain what terminal meant. You know, we had to explain what a lifespan, like what that my lifespan was and how it differed from normal people's lifespans. It was just a matter of sort of being open with them, but not too open. If they asked us anything about it, we would tell them, but we didn't be like, we need to talk about this. It was just sort of around us, and if they asked a question or if I had forgotten something, it was, you know, I was like, oh, it's, you know, I couldn't remember something, you know, and they'd be like, because of your tumor? And I said, yeah, probably, but who knows, I might just be forgetful today, you know? So it was just sort of like a way of making it not a big deal, and not like sitting them down and crying and telling them that this is what's happening. It's just like a question, you answer it. Just like any other question, like how many times do I have to go pee today? 10, you know, like, you know, it's just a conversation that is not a big deal. So we talk about it enough that they don't think it's a big deal. And that, I think, is important for them.